35.
Caveats?
Hmm?
Any caveats on the property?
Did you just say that?
What?
You just said.
When?
There you go. Sorry. Just having the most incredible deja vu.
When?
When? I knew you were going to say that. Say something else.
What?
No. That wasn't it.
Wasn't what?
No. It's gone. You were saying?
At 40 now, 50 if you like now. At 5.5 in front against my starter. Taking 10 still, sir. At 550,000, 60 if you like. Back to the starter. Have you back in at 5.6. 70 if you like now. At 5.6 and 70 if you like. At 70 now. At 80, can I say? At 570,000, 80. Back in with my starter at 580. 90, can I say now? All done. All finished. Taking 10, sir. At 590,000 now. Taking 600 now. First call, you're out there. Surely not. It's good buying there. It's only money. Relax, spend freely. At 590,000, we'll take your five if you like then, sir. At 595?
600.
600 straight back in against you now. Five. At 605, calling 10 now. 610, 15 if you want it now. Got 615, 20 now, can I say? At 620, at 25 now if you like. Got 25, 30 now. At 625, 30's here. 35 and?
640.
640, good to have you in. Welcome to the bidding, sir. 50 if you like. Got 50 here. 60. 60 now. 70 if you like now. At 670 bid now.
680.
80 here. Back in at 80, we'll take your 90 now at 680,000. All done. Hopefully, it's been silent. Going, going, going. And so, congratulations. Give a round of applause. Well bought, sir. On behalf of Philip Lang Real Estate, congratulations to our purchaser. Ladies and gentlemen, have a wonderful afternoon. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
What you thought to go for?
I thought you just under
Philip Lang Real Estate. Mate, come on. Have you done any developments like this in the area before?
Oh, this will be the first this side of town.
All right. What have you done previously?
I can't fix the piece of this.
Frank.
Hello.
Good result today. No. Good result. Well done. You're in a mood.
No, I'm not. Just a bird shat on me.
That's supposed to be good luck, isn't it?
Well, if I catch a little prick.
Why don't you go outside and whack the sold sticker up for us? Nice jaunty angle.
See you, mate.
Yeah, see you later, mate.
Hey, darling, how you going? You're a prick, mate. Early 500, you said. Mid fives at most.
Well, market is a bit more volatile than usual.
That's bullshit, and you know it. You're a bullshit artist. How can you say mid fives at the inspection and then on auction day? The property isn't even on the market until 650.
I didn't.
You bloody did, mate. This is the eighth time. Jamison Street last September, Harrow Road, Langley Street before Christmas. There's got to be some tribunal or some ombudsman or something we can go to.
Yeah, well, there's a, you know...
Sorry to interrupt. Philip Lang Real Estate.
Yeah, Adam Trigoni.
G'day, Adam, and?
This is Julie.
And who's this little scoundrel?
This is Ben.
You got your mum's good looks, haven't you, mate? Well, with any luck, you've got your old man's nouse. Yeah, I was just saying to Frank here earlier, wasn't I, Frank?
Yes,
I was just saying, there's a smart bidder. Here's a man who understands the property market at the moment. Well, you dropped out of the bidding, that was exactly right. Exactly the property's worth.
Yeah, right.
Well, why don't we these cowboys get their money from? What did it go for in the end? A bit north of 680, was it?
680.
680, was it? Yeah, 680. Silly money. I dips me lead to you. I was just saying to Frank inside, wasn't I, Frank?
Yeah,
very good bidding on your part. We should go, incidentally, if we're going to get to that other thing.
Oh, yeah, the thing.
Oh, the other one. Wonderful to meet you. Cheers, wonderful. Mate.
Thanks for that.
There is actually something I want to show you. Where are you parked?
Oh, just over there?
Yeah, well, follow me. It's just around the corner.
Right.
Do
His hand pass missed Campbell. Sorsey was there, but James Gowan steals. Thomas gets the hand pass. It goes straight past Sainsbury. Diagon on the muff up to McGuinness. His kick finds a target.
I'll see you in the kitchen. There's more. There's a nativity scene.
Deceased estate?
No, not yet. Any day now, though, I'm told. Thoughts?
Depends. What do you want to hear?
Oh, I want to hear your thoughts.
Well, I'd say it was a good listing. North-facing backyard. Deep block. Wide frontage. Leafy tree-lined street.
Well, write me the board.
What, are you offering me the listing, Philip?
No, I'm thinking of offering you the listing. Don't look at me like that, Frank. You know why.
Right.
You know what I'm thinking.
Uh-huh. It was a good, solid result this morning.
Well, it was a result, wasn't it?
No, it was a good, solid result. Do you know how to turn this thing off?
No, it's on a timer. I don't know where the switch is.
Well, be at the end of the hose, don't you reckon?
You'd think, yeah.
Mm. Anyway, good solid results all
day. Yeah, well, Frank, Libby is back at the office working tirelessly on the medallion. I think it's at the engraver.
Solid result.
Yeah, I believe solid result is the actual inscription, Frank. Property would have sold itself. There's another way of looking at it, Frank. Double-fronted brick, a nanosecond from schools, cafes and public transport. Look at a 12-year-old great-nephew, Frank. His knuckles touch the ground slightly as he walks, and he breathes only through the mouth. I reckon he could have got a similar result with this thing. And I had the Ubermensch wielding the gavel for you. He's good.
Yeah, he's good, isn't he?
He's very good.
Well, why don't you give a listen to Hamish? You know, if you don't have a problem with breathing through the mouth and dragging knuckles.
Hamish is not in a...
The pigeons don't shit on Hamish.
Hamish is not in a mood, is what I was going to say, but you're right. Pigeons don't shit on Hamish. Hamish went to a private school. All I'm asking, Frank, is that you have a crack at writing the board. You'd think I was asking for the sealing of the bloody Magna Carta.
Attention, first-time buyers and investors. This beautiful two-bedroom home with open fireplaces and potential off-street parking, subject to council approval, boasts a wonderful opportunity to improve. You could knock down this much-loved family home, whose last occupant is currently wintering in a nursing home, public nursing home, somewhere in a growth corridor, while her scabrous offspring, the pernicious little shits, she butted into the world, tried to sell her memory soft, blue-chip locale, right from under her. You could renovate or you could raise this meticulous and much-loved family home. Jeez, I'm sorry, Phil. I'm really sorry. Look, it's your fault you started this. Look, it's my Tourette's, all right? I've got Tourette's. I wasn't talking about you.
Well, yeah, you were.
No, I wasn't. Really, I wasn't.
Sorry, I have to take this. Hang on. Yep. Why are you a shit mother?
I am.
No, you're not shit at it.
Frank busted his arm.
All right. But
I haven't been there. I haven't been there all year.
Well, come on, it's not like he's dead. I mean, it's not like, okay, road trauma. He's not diseased.
You should go.
Oh, I just got it.
I panicked. I called the first number on speed dial.
I'm on speed dial.
Oh, Frank, just shut up. Shut up.
Why are you acting so defensively?
I'm not.
Yeah, you are. Otherwise, why would you be saying please?
Because that's how it is now. I'm either saying please or sorry. Or explaining myself to somebody. Checkout chicks, the newsagent, the props guy, the people that did the guttering.
God, what's wrong with the guttering?
Just go.
Okay. Well, you know, you've got to stop thinking that you're the shit one. And you've got to start, you know, putting some distance between us, you know, properly, like you're supposed to.
Yeah.
I mean, for starters, take my name off speed dial. You know, it's like this divorce is not going to work for me. I mean, it's weird enough as it is.
How is he?
Oh, look, he's fine. Just a brain stick fracture.
You okay, sweetie?
He's fine. I'll x-ray him again in a fortnight, and there really shouldn't be any reason why we can't take the cast off after that.
Frank?
Frank?
How's it going?
Good.
How's it going?
Good.
Broke your arm, the same.
Yeah, fracture.
Rehearsal?
Yeah, rehearsals.
Was it dress rehearsals? Or was this what all the kids are wearing these days?
We better go. You okay, hon?
Yep.
Do I need to sign him out or something?
I'll look after you up at the front desk. I'll just grab the paperwork and meet you there.
Great.
This isn't entirely appropriate, I know, but can I just say I love you in the show?
Oh, thanks. Yeah, thanks.
You really like the show?
Yeah. So it's generally pretty accurate.
Really?
Well, no one actually says stat in Australia. That's more of an American thing.
So what do they say?
Quick. Quickly. Mm. Oh, please.
Unit 256, Ostrow Street, London Park. Ideal for permanent living or as an investment, this easy-to-maintain one-bedroom ground-floor apartment provides a wonderful opportunity for cosmetic improvement. Property also offers kitchen and laundry facilities. Get away from it all in this quiet, secluded cul-de-sac situation. Yeah.
Hello, dear.
Who's this?
It's your mother.
Mum? Really?
Yes, really. Oh, God, you must be tired.
No. Well, yeah, I'm...
Oh,
just
poor love.
It's just that you never called me dear before.
Well, of course I have. What are you talking about?
Or sweetheart, for that
matter. Oh, that is right. I call you sweetheart all the time.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Okay. Oh, fine. How are you?
The hip's playing up a bit in this weather.
Your hip? What's wrong with the hip?
Same old trouble. We know it gets a bit stiff.
Right.
Are you smoking?
No.
Yes, you are. I can tell.
How? How can you tell?
Well, I'm your mother. And I can tell by the way you're breathing.
Mum, I breathe all the time. Just because I'm breathing doesn't mean I'm smoking.
Now, Dad, please don't let's argue.
I'm not. I'm just saying that non-smokers breathe.
No, I didn't call to have another argument.
Oh, I'm putting it out, right? I'm just putting it out.
Do you want me to worry about you some more?
No, look, sorry, you're right.
And
sorry.
What happened? Did I wean you too early?
What?
You need to be on the booze a bit longer.
No!
I mean, what do you want, sweetheart? Peripheral vascular disease, heart disease, cancer of the liver, lungs, prostate cancer, gangrene, take your pick. They list them all on the packaging.
Hmm? Are you all right?
Well, actually, no, because my hip's giving me misery.
Yeah, no, I mean, you sound different.
Well, I would, wouldn't I? You know, it's been weeks since you've bothered to call your poor, lonely, grey-haired old mother. Months.
Oh, hang on. I mean, I've been really busy.
Oh,
and...
well, during which time your fingers got broken. Now, I'm only saying that you could call your mother on occasion.
Yeah, I know, I could, I should, but, you know, I mean, have you read the papers lately? Have you come across the word recession in any of them?
Oh, no, that's hardly an excuse.
I know it's not an excuse. I've just got a lot of... I've
just got a lot on my plate at the moment.
Now, you told me that your job was recession-proof.
I wish.
Oh, well. Oh, I know. The world has gone silly. You know, I'm on this six-month waiting list for this hip. And they're calling it elective surgery, and that's just because I don't have a liver hanging out of me.
Right.
And they've got the gall to call it rationalism. Anyway, that's not your problem.
We didn't ever speak like this before, did we?
Well, how do you mean?
Well, I mean, I never thought that you had a world view. Maybe because I don't have one. I mean, Wendy's always saying I don't.
Right.
Anyway, look, I'm really sorry. I'm really sorry that, you know, I didn't call you.
A sweetheart.
Yeah.
Who's Wendy?
Wendy. Wendy. My wife, Wendy.
But you're not married.
Oh, great, thanks. Yeah, okay, Mum. Yeah, ex-wife. Thank you very much.
Oh, no, look, you're just saying yourself that we've just been having the first decent conversation we've had for quite some time, and then you go and you ruin it by being a smart aleck again. Honestly, Damien, I just...
Pardon?
You heard me.
Who is this?
Who do you think it is?
Emily Mullard?
Oh, come on. Who in heaven's name is Emily Mullard?
Which number did you dial?
Oh, my God. Oh, I haven't, have I? 7010-6389?
Yeah, it's 89630.
Oh, my God. I am so, so sorry.
It's okay. No, don't apologize.
No,
don't worry about it.
No,
it's really
sorry.
Fine. It's okay. Like, hello, it's Frank Mullard. We were speaking earlier.
How did you get this number?
Oh, there's a redial thingy on the phone. Press *10# and the number pops up.
Oh.
Anyway, I'm sorry about before, and I don't mean to trouble you. I'm just gonna say it. My mum died late last year. And I don't know what you're thinking. I mean, how could I possibly think you were her if she's... You know, if she's dead. I just wanted you to know that I'm not weird or unbalanced. I don't even read horoscopes. You just sound so much like her. Your voice. I'll let you go. I just wanted to let you go. But I wanted to explain.
Frank?
I should let you go.
Frank, is it?
Mm-hmm.
What did you say her name was?
Who?
Who you were talking to.
Oh, Emily.
Not too many natives about. That's good, I suppose. Oh, Christ, look at him now. Oh, Jesus, I can't look at this now. Number one, talk. Point the bloody gun at him. Frighten him, George. Right, I owe you, big government Australia, and what I am.
Dad, it's all right. It's all right.
Oh, all right, good. You tell him. Tell him we'll pay him.
Dad, it's Philip. Yeah, it's Philip, Dad. Yes. I'm here.
Philip, sir, you have to write on a bit of paper. Yes. Have you got a bit of paper? Someone's getting a bit of paper. Big government, Australia, belong me. Yes.
morning. Any messages?
On the spike.
These are all for Hamish.
Yep.
You still up there?
Yep.
You don't know what a flash player is, do you, by any chance?
No.
Why can I not get onto my own website if I haven't got one?
I don't know. What's going on with Olivia's haircut?
Oh, yeah. God knows.
I mean, she didn't have surgery, did she?
I wouldn't think so. Not over the weekend. Do you think there'd be potential property buyers who haven't got a flash player?
I don't know. Probably.
What is a flash player?
It's not just a haircut, is it?
I paid her bloody email friends good money for that. You want a check, don't you? You know it won't clear till Friday.
No. No. I came to apologise.
All right.
I just like us to go on pretending that I'm not...
It's asking me to push OK. I'm not going to get a virus, am I, if I push
know.
OK?
I don't know.
No, you wouldn't know. I'm going to push OK. Whoa! Incidentally, I went and saw the old man after you and I were speaking on Saturday.
Oh, Christ, I'm sorry.
No, shut up. It's all good.
No, I'm really, really sorry.
He's fine. He's fine. Honestly, he's fine.
Right. Something interesting happened today.
You don't know what an error 101 is, do you?
It's semi-related. I thought I got a phone call from my mum on Saturday.
Your mother? Well, that'd be... Didn't your mum...
Yeah, late last year.
...pass away? Yeah, I remember you saying.
Cervical cancer.
Yeah, that'd do it. And?
No, just... It was just the wrong number.
And?
And I thought it was her.
Your mum?
Hmm.
The dead one?
No, it was just the wrong number.
Yeah, you said.
I just wasn't sure, and, you know, she sounded like... Might be an interesting person.
Just excuse me, Frank. I'm sorry to do this to you. I will have to take this. Hello? Yes, he's right here now. Certainly. It's for you, Frank.
Who is it?
It's Freud. He says it's urgent.
Tell him I'll call him back.
There's a tone of concern in his voice, Frank.
Right.
Okay, yes, Vienna. How many bedrooms?
Is he all right?
I don't know. He saw his old man on the weekend.
No, otherwise.
How would I know? How are you?
How do you mean?
Are you okay?
Yeah, fine.
You haven't said anything about my hair?
No, I haven't. Look good when it's finished.
Philip said you might be in a mood.
No, I like it.
I have to take these. Philip Lang, real estate. How can I help
Frank?
You? Fran? I'm afraid he's in a meeting at the moment. Is that a message?
It's lunchtime.
Okay, no problem. Is that 4 o'clock?
Really?
You're complaining about I'm coughing and you're on a flight path? Just hit the ball. No. I'm happy to sign an affidavit saying I saw that. Are there any downhill holes here?
Yeah, this one. But you've got to go the other way.
Oh, you're joking, aren't you, Frank? You're very funny.
No, come on, have a go.
You're being facetious, I think.
No, I'm being optimistic. I have faith in you, mate.
Freud and I were just discussing your mother again. He thinks you should take the day off. Not suggesting for a moment that's not what you're doing, but could you do something sensible at some point? Why don't you go and see your dead mother?
All righto.
Now, shut up. I'm out here to relax. Oh, how very relaxing. I'll be much better now. You know, every time you walk in the room, lately, I can hear your theme music. It's not a bad life, Frank. Being an agent. We stand in the middle of an economic equation, adding to the price of something without producing it. We show people a house. If they like it, we explain to them why they like it. If they don't like it, we've got another one we're desperate to show them. We think might suit them better. We're probably a byproduct of a bloody divorce industry. Somebody's life's not going terribly well. Good news for us. It's not the most difficult work in the world.
28 Macklin Avenue, St. Mary's. Attractive Tudor-style home on a good-sized allotment. Solid brick, wide double frontage veranda. Quiet tree-lined street. Set an attractive garden setting.
Frank.
You must be. Come in, please. I'm sorry about the mess.
Oh, no, it's fine. I understand.
That sounded out, dear. Yes, that's good.
Santa Goose. Well, well, Santa Pig.
That's very good, Omar. You've done very well today. Now, off you pop. Take your books. I will give you... Now, this is your reader for next week.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you.
This is all about how English was invented.
Yes, it's about where English was invented. Off you go.
Thank you, miss.
Same time next Monday. Well, I've had the kettle on. I'll make us some tea, shall I?
Sure. Well-proportioned, light-filled entranceway. At least two spacious foyer with original features. Generously proportioned living room with north-facing lead-like windows. Art deco ceiling fixtures, gas heating, and... Well,
be an incredibly gifted kleptomaniac who he finds from the library are worth more than this house.
These are all mine. I used to work in the state library 30 years. Now I can't bear to see a book out of place. Oh, it's so silly, really, you know, because I go into other people's houses and I might see a book that's lying on an occasional table. I get quite short-tempered.
I straighten pictures, plan renos. I was thinking of doing something like this, my place. What's he do?
Who? Oh, Damien. Oh, he's in HR, IT, or... Well, to tell you the truth, I don't honestly know, but I know it's an acronym, something to do with computers, and I believe he does quite well out of it. Now, do you take milk?
Oh, yes, thank you.
And sugar?
Yeah, just one. Force of habit, again.
How long have you been?
8 months. It's not really panning out. I mean, we get on better. You know, than when we were married.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
No, it's all right. I mean, we're working through it.
I'm sorry because I know this is none of my business. But if you're still getting on, why...
Well, I mean, it's not anything... It's not anything specific, really. It's just, she suddenly got famous, and it was, you know, it was quite shocking. She's an actor, so we didn't really think it was going anywhere. Everything was fine when she was doing co-op. You know, those magical realist plays from South America with a talking cat.
Mm-hmm.
Now she's got 220,000 followers on Twitter.
Oh, wow. And would I know of her, do you think?
I don't know. Do you watch Major Surgery?
It's not Wendy McKinnon.
Yeah.
Oh, well, they say she's wonderful.
Yeah, I recently heard her work described as fairly accurate.
And what do you do, Frank, if you don't mind my asking?
I'm retired.
Really?
I invented Tetris.
Right.
I also model. Menswear mainly.
Hmm.
And right now, I am doing volunteer work for an impoverished realtor in Umley.
There we are.
Force of habit again. I don't like to say that I work in real estate. Not because it's evil, there's no argument there. But it's just every time I say it, someone always says, oh, so what's this place worth, you reckon?
Right. So
mid-fives to early sixes?
600,000 for this place?
Yeah, 650 on a good day.
But I thought after the recession that...
Yeah, well, you know. Everybody's scared of the stock market and the cash is getting silly, so bricks and mortar. It's the best place to park your money.
Oh, I thought everybody had lost their money.
The normals. But who did they lose it to? The investors. They can still call the queen their auntie.
But But all the papers say...
You don't believe what you read in the papers, do you? Money never goes away. Just changes hands. Thanks for the tea.
No, no, thank you for coming all this way.
No, it's no problem. We're calling this an inner suburb these days.
Well, goodbye.
Thanks for the tea. Oh, while I think about it, somebody's turned your man upside down.
Oh, no, no, it's meant to be like that.
No, no, it's meant to, you know...
Come here, and I'll show you. Come on. Now stand there, and look. Look down. Now, look up. What do you see?
Established garden setting with bright sunny outlook onto one of the area's most distinctive avenues. This well-presented property boasts easy access to local amenities, including attractive parks and gardens. Don't let this opportunity pass you by.
Did you leave something?
No. I just wanted to ask if we could, if we could do this again. I don't really feel like I got the chance to apologize for the other night. And
you seem perfectly...
No, can we please just not talk about that? I just want to,
Frank.
No, look, it's coming.
Frank.
No, I've got it.
Would you like to come round to lunch on Sunday? I will do a roast.
Terrific. Can I bring something?
Just bring yourself. Good.
Right,
1 o'clock.
Right. 1 o'clock, Sunday.
Right. 1300 hours.
Roger that. One.
Sorry, caller two. Look, that's not right. Caller three. Look, what do you think the secret sound is?
It's the sound of someone hearing.
Man, I really thought you found a moment.
Oh, good.
Really strong.
Thanks, Gary.
Yeah, wonderful manager. Maybe you could try an accent.
You look like Elm Street.
Yeah.
Excuse me, can I talk to you for a minute, please?
You know, I suppose...
You're working?
I
want to see safety advisor right now. There must be somebody from OH&S here. Go get him. Go. Right now. Go get him. Scott! Bring me a safety on. Some safety vests as well.
Yes.
Narrow Street.
I had a farm in Africa.
Put this on. Can you get me a bigger size?
Sorry. Sorry, Gary, what were you saying?
Well, what I was saying is I really think you should consider living in London. It's great. It's expensive, but it's a nice place. I got a little surprise,
though. That's good.
Plenty of work on the West Street.
What we want?
Good.
Great.
Love you.
This should be calm. Around the garden.
Excuse me, Gary, just 1 second.
You know, it wasn't Narrow Street, it was Halle Berry.
Ah, here's my little longer. Right. Every day from now on. One of these. Hard hat.
You have to stop pulling this stuff on the crew, Frank.
Why? They assume that anybody that walks in there in a suit's from the network, and this is from Fletcher Jones. Give that to Gary, will you? Anyway, I used to dig it when I used to do it.
Yeah, well, this isn't the old days.
Maybe not the Earth.
Just trying to do their jobs.
Thanks, Brendan.
Yes, bringing joy and hope to millions.
Oh, well, at least they make something that didn't exist once. You sell what's already there, you're in no position to judge.
Right. Fair play, sorry.
See, it's trouble with you, Frank. You'd much rather apologise afterwards and be reasonable beforehand. I mean, what's with you?
What do you mean? I'm fine.
Exactly. Why are you in such a good mood?
FYI, I've done some research. People don't actually say stat in Australia. What's Gary doing here?
He doesn't have to go to a Thursday now.
What's he doing in London?
Nothing, just panto to clear a tax debt.
Oh, no, he isn't.
Hi, lady. You're not seeing anyone, are you?
No.
It'll be fine if you are.
But, right.
In the middle.
And how isn't it fine?
Oh, don't get prickly. I'm just saying, you're acting like you've got a leg over.
It'd be fantastic if you had, to be honest. Not just for me, for society as a whole. Oh, shit, you got to be there in 10.
Righto.
Frank, be nice, please.
Righto. To who?
Sorry already.
Oh, sorry, mate. Mum didn't tell me till an hour ago. Lucky I had nothing on.
Like what? Hear the storm. Line, who's there besides?
Who's there besides?
Foul?
Foul weather. One-minded like the weather. Most unquietly. Sorry, Line.
I know you. Where's the king?
I know you. Where's the king? Contending with the fretful elements. Bids the earth blow into...
Wind?
Bids the wind blow the earth into the sea, or swell the curled waters above the main, that things might cease. Tears his white hair, which the impetuous blasts with eyeless rage catch their fury, and make nothing of. Strives in his little world of man to outscorn the to and fro conflicting wind and rain, wherein the cub-drawn bear would couch, the lion and the belly-pinched wolf, keep their fur dry, unbonneted he runs, and bids what will take all. Line?
But who is with him?
But who is with him? Sorry. None but the fool who labours to outjest his heart-struck injuries.
That's cool.
Good.
I spy with my little eye something starting with W.
Windscreen.
Yeah, all right, fair enough. Your turn.
Something starting with E.
Edwardian Villa.
No.
Eastern Suburbs.
No.
All right, I give up.
Estranged husband.
Dalkeith Avenue, Hyde Park. Untouched period charm in sought-after location. Generously proportioned rooms characterise the appeal of this late Victorian villa-style home with original features. This meticulously renovated family home is ideal for entertaining. It's a short walk from a prestige retail and vibrant cafe district.
You're not coming in, are you?
No. Just want to take a quick squiz at the guttering. Looks fine. What are you on about?
Duh, shut it fixed. By some men.
I'll talk to you later.
Property also boasts recently refurbished guttering.
Hi, Bridge Wendy McKinnon. Please leave a message after the beep and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
Hi, it's me. I just finished watching Frank Jr. rehearsing and, Look, I think we should talk, maybe. He's home. He's fine. And, gutters look good. Okay. We'll talk later. It's Frank, by the way.
Yep.
All right, what's happened?
Nothing, why?
Is he all right?
Yeah, he's fine.
What happened?
Nothing.
So what's with the we should talk?
What?
He left
a message. You like it.
Frank, we should talk.
Oh.
Yeah.
Just tell me he's all right.
He's fine. Sorry. I was just watching him at rehearsal and he's good.
Sorry?
He's good.
He's talented, at acting. And I just wondering if we should do something about that.
Well, did you tell him?
I'm kidding. No, you don't tell him things like that. I mean, should we send him to one of those special schools?
Frank, I'll talk to you later.
No, hang on, you know what I mean. One of those schools for kids who can't play footy. Team Waltham Street Prospect, mortgagee auction, with period charm, excellent floor plan, secure parking at the rear, subject to council approval. This home will excite the discerning inner city buyer looking for convenience and style. Central bathroom, gas heating and appliances, north facing rear garden, ideal.
It looks like a deceased estate.
Why? Did you find the body? We looked everywhere for it.
Well, if it is a deceased estate, why does it say mortgagee auction on the board?
Well, the mortgagee is deceased. I believe that's why she's selling. Excuse me. Not to be rude, but this isn't in your price range.
Yeah, what it's listed here is...
Yeah, I know what it says. I put it there.
Last, I'm so sorry, Frank. Oh, good Lord, no wonder you're late. Look at you, all handsome.
I'm with this for you, Mum. It's Anzac Day.
Oh, don't be silly, I know that. How was it?
Oh, it's pretty good. Same as last year. Oh, hello.
Frank, this is Damien. Damien Frank.
G'day.
Now, I'll take that. Sit down. I'll serve up before it gets cold.
That looks pretty swish. So.
Better than the bully, eh? Who have I? If that one is for me, there's plenty more of them. Better than the bully. The tins aren't rusty like the other ones, are they?
Yeah, hear that, mate. Shush. You love that, don't you?
Oh, yeah, it's good.
Sarah tells me that you're in IT.
That's right, yeah. I run IT for the HR department of the IAAF.
Oh. Okay, I see. CPUs?
Oh, yeah, that's correct. We maintain a virtualized data center cluster with high bandwidth offsite replication for redundancy. Spin up VMs when the IAs get out of spec, which could be either from our intranet or internet-hosted web apps. Got to watch out for SNMP traps, a target of 5.9's uptime SLA. And of course, obviously, security is a big issue, so we dig through lines of code to check for possible SQL injection exploits. What about you, Frank?
I'm in real estate.
Right. So, What's this place worth, do you reckon?
Mum, what...
No, 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 it goes in there.
There used to be in there.
Yeah.
So, I can help you, one. Is there another tea towel I can dry?
Don't be silly, you're a guest. Go and sit down. Damien can do it.
So, I know you said you met over the phone. I'm just still a little kind of...
You must live in Linden Park.
Graham Street.
Yeah, I'm around the corner on Ostrom.
Right, right.
Yeah, and we have similar phone numbers. And I think that the threes and the sixes got turned around. I mean, she was calling you, but
uh-huh.
She got me instead.
Right.
And, you know, we got to talking and, yeah. You say it out loud, it does sound a little off-key.
Yeah.
There's tea if you want it when you finish.
Thanks, Mum.
And don't throw the bats over the fence like you usually do, Damien. It upsets the Tai Chi, ladies.
Mmm. That's good. Thanks for lunch.
My pleasure.
Damien?
Frank?
It was nice to meet a member of the armed forces, especially in peacetime.
Thank you.
Of course you can.
God. Sarah, how many are you here? Anything like that?
Yes, well, no, I've just been visiting a friend.
Oh, okay. Nothing good, I hope.
No, she's quite unwell.
Oh, sorry to hear that. Oh, this is my son, Frank. Frank.
Hello.
Sorry about this, Mum. This is Aunt. It's like unpasteurized cheese from the 19th century. Everything all right?
Oh, yes, yes, I'm fine.
Sarah?
Yes, Frank.
Do you need a ride home or something?
No, Frank. Thank you, but I'll be fine.
Who's that?
Yeah. She's, his friend. She was a friend. I've been meaning to tell you something. The other day when I was watching rehearsal, I mean, the cast took me out of it a little bit, took me out of the scene. I don't think that they had Plaster of Paris in the Tudor period. I mean, you know, they could have had some rudimentary splint arrangement, I suppose. But look, the point I was trying to make is that what I'm trying to tell you is that you're good. He's really good. And I'll be honest, I mean, it blew me away. And, you know, I just think that you should... No, mate, don't cry. I mean, I wouldn't have told you if you were going to... All right. Yeah, good talk. You all right, mate?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Watch out for the cars. Good day, Jane.
Hello.
Have you been crying?
Yeah.
What happened? What have you done?
Nothing.
What did you do? What did he say to you?
Nothing, I'm fine. It's just I do.
What have one, Miss Mullard?
We should go. Thanks for picking him up. Frank, oh.
Just passing, I thought I'd pop in.
I see. You're not an ambulance chaser, are you, Frank?
What? Who said that? What? Damien?
Well, we're a bit unsure because you seem very nice.
Finally, have a good week. Just give me his number. I'll call him.
No.
No. An ambulance chaser. Give me his number.
No, I don't want you upsetting him.
You said yourself he wasn't combat trained.
Frank, he is my son, not you, him. Now, I know what you've been doing, and up to now, I've not seen any harm in it, but she's gone, Frank, and it doesn't matter how nice you are to me. It doesn't change anything, and no matter what you think is wrong with you, you're just going to have to fix that on your own. Because I am not her. I am not family.
No, you're right. You're not. By the way, your mat's upside down. Your mat is upside down!
Oh my God. He's on to rest. 40 milligrams of adrenaline. Stat. Let's talk to Mason.
He's not going well. His BP and heart rate are still falling.
We need to get some adrenaline in him now.
Any more, and we'll risk it.
Stat. Unless we stop him defibrillating.
Frank Mullard.
It's me.
Yeah.
I tried to call earlier, but you weren't answering.
No.
Oh, please don't be like this. I've rung to apologize.
It's okay.
And I was wondering if...
Mm-hmm.
You see, I don't have a driver's license, and...
Oh. Well, it's okay, you can use mine. 114 Mount Alexander Road, Walkerville.
It's gone.
Let's have a squiz anyway. Substantially sized allotment in prime location. Ideal for investors. We'll create your own vision, subject to council approval. Let your imagination run wild.
The kitchen was here. And there were always lovely smells. Which was always baking. My mum was always baking. And we had a lean-to here. And hot summer nights, they let me sleep out on the day bed. And I'd be awake until all hours, counting the stars.
How many were there back then?
I don't think I ever got that far. Oh, and there was a wonderful nectarine tree here. And lavender and rosemary all along the fence. I was always getting stung by bees. Oh, dear. It's so terrible to see it like this. My father was very proud it was a working garden. There was a vine he put in over there. That will be over 70 years old by now. I thought it was bigger. It always seemed bigger.
Yeah. They always do. Come on.
We'll see you next one.
Yeah.
Okay. 14 Macclesfield Street, Clarence Gardens. Double-fronted family residence in highly sought-after area. Scope to further improve.
Thank you.
Hey.
That are spruce or fir?
It's a blue cedar, Cedric Atlantica. Look, I can pick it up for you, honey.
Frank Mollard, Philip Lang Real Estate, card. You can keep that.
Yeah, cool, man. Yeah, nice fun.
Yeah, it's the Seraph.
Yeah. Yeah, we're actually renting at the moment. So.
Yeah, Kenley, we're over
there. Yeah, me and the cats. Are, you know, we're rehearsing. So.
That was you? Yeah. Wow. I thought you were spinning some vinyl. I thought it was like Sly and the Family Stone.
That's not Sly, man. I wish.
Anyway, back to me. Sure. My associate and I are in the area for today, and today only, to evaluate properties that Philip Lang Real Estate has identified as having potential. Look, let me be frank with you. I need a name.
Kyle.
Kyle. Right, Kyle. My name's Frank.
Yeah, you said.
Anyway, I'm just wondering if we could. May we come in and have a quick squeeze?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, of course, yeah. Come on in.
Thank you.
No worries.
We won't take up much of your time, like 5 minutes or something.
Well, I can give you the tour.
No, you can. We'll be right.
Oh, I'm supposed to see you. Right.
Yeah, no problem.
Light-filled entrance leads to spacious kitchen meals area.
I remember these curtains. They're the same. They're the same curtains.
Cancer. How long do they give you? I can't think of any other reason that we'd be here.
I'll be all right, Frank. They say I'll be all right.
That's not true. That's not based on a true story. But they said that. We'd be at the zoo looking at meerkats and eating ice cream.
I have an intracranial cerebral aneurysm, and they can't. I don't know how long. It's not as if they give you a date.
Damn, you know.
He thinks I'm just off colour.
So he just thinks that you have his group.
No, that's not lying. But the hit won't be done because of the aneurysm, they can't give me a general anesthetic. They don't put me under a general anesthetic.
Okay. Thanks for telling me. Oh, thanks very much.
Yeah, no worries. Hang on a sec.
Dude, where are that Feb 15 demos? We'll just be off.
No, that's cool. Hey, check it out. Yeah? Yeah, it's just like an EP.
Oh, good.
Yeah, sort of like a, between albums, kind of limited release.
Right.
Yeah, double A side.
Right.
We're going through a transitional period.
Mm.
Shifting our influences away from Miles, Pastorius, to a funk.
Mm. Yeah. Rock is dead.
Rock is dead.
One newspaper says it.
Yeah. So, what's this, what's the place worth, you reckon?
Oh, this place?
Yeah.
As it is? Oh, mostly sentimental value.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, no worries. Oh, well, nice meeting you too. Lady, madam.
Thank you.
Man.
Good. How long does this go on for?
This track. 137 minutes.
Frank, I'd be glad if you didn't say anything to Damon. I know you wouldn't. You're silly asking. Would you like to come in for a cuppa? What was she like?
Your mum. Hmm. Old. Older than she should have been. Disappointed.
In what?
Me? Dad? Self, I suppose. In life. She always smelled of tart hairspray. And she kept a pharmacy of placebos in a bedside drawer. She seemed to be on hold 2 hours a day waiting to talk to somebody at 5AA Talkback. I remember at Christmas, she would put as many 5-cent coins in my bit of the pudding as she could. Must have been $6 worth. I mean, there's more coins than there was pudding. And I read somewhere that the nickel in 5-cent coins gave off toxins when cooked. That turns out she was trying to kill me.
With kindness, though.
What's that?
It's a water feature.
What's he doing here?
Philip had it put in this morning. Harris Real Estate has got one, apparently.
Don't you like it?
I have to go to the toilet all the time now, like a nana.
Is he in?
He's around the corner, checking out the billboard.
We have a billboard.
And the water feature.
What do you reckon?
Nice fun.
What did you think of the water feature?
Give you a shout out to me. You alright?
Yeah. Yeah, all good. Piss off, right?
No, well, that's not true. That's not based on a true story. What's going on?
Nothing going on, Frank. Everything's dandy.
Mm. He's a true old man.
Okay, yeah. Don't take this the wrong way, Frank, but I'm blaming you.
Right. I must warn you, there's a queue.
This is costing me a fortune.
Hmm. I want you to meet someone. I want you to meet my dead mother.
You bloody double-crossed me, that's what I remember. You said you'd be at the beach. And you were bloody well there.
Dad?
Mm.
It's me. Philip, again.
Oh, yes.
Dad, I brought someone to see you.
Hello, Noel. I'm Sarah.
No, not this one. I want to talk to the other one. Gave me the bloody malaria pills. They're making me worse, I reckon. I keep vomiting the things up.
Noel, that's all done with now, and you don't have to take them anymore, if you don't want to.
I hope I don't. Bloody sense.
It's all done with now, and you're back home now. It's all over with. You know, you're going to be up and about in no time.
Yeah. Mm. When can I see Beth?
Soon, love. You'll see her soon.
Yeah, it's all good. It's
all good. Thanks. Philip, did your father ever mention a Captain Simpson?
He might have. It comes pretty thick and fast these days.
No, before.
Oh, before he never talked about anything.
Hmm. Captain Simpson was the commander of your father's artillery unit. And when the Japanese landed in Rabaul, the men were cut off. They were totally isolated. And Simpson had to take those men. There were 40 of them, including your father, through the jungle to safety. It took them 3 months. And later Simpson died of malaria in Port Moresby. Your father credits Simpson with saving his life. And Simpson's first name, his given name,
right?
Mm. Well, Philip, it was very nice to meet you and your father. You're all right.
Yeah.
Oh.
No, sorry. I'll look you inside if you want.
No, thank you.
Sure? Well,
no.
Fine. I don't know.
Freud was right.
He was onto something.
He did very well out of it.
Well, I'm told.
Not like us, though.
No. Not even close, mate.
Wrong racket.
I prithee break. Look up, my lord. Vex not his ghost. Oh, let him pass. He hates him much that would upon the rack of this tough world stretch him out longer. The wonder he's endured so long.
The weight of this sadness we must obey. Speak what we feel, not what we ought to say. The oldest have borne most. We that are young shall not see as much, nor live as long. You were the best.
Really?
Central group.
Mm-hmm.
Music not bad. Yeah. Costume. Pants loads come up great.
Really?
You and Edgar and...
Albany.
You look like out of an ad.
Frank.
No, just kidding, mate. Good effort.
Well.
It was great.
So who's Connell?
Rachel.
She isn't here, mister.
I called her an hour ago.
I knocked loud.
Loudly. It's Frank Muller. Could you give me a call back as soon as you get this message? You can reach me on this number. Thanks.
We've met, I think. I'm Dr. Elliot. His son had a fracture. Are you a friend of the family?
No, all of them, no. Were you downstairs?
Yeah, I've been advanced up to palliative.
Right. Palliative. That's where you can't fix them, right?
That's correct.
How the hell is that a promotion?
Mr. Muller, I've been thinking about what you said. How's that a promotion?
Look, I'm really sorry about that. But, you know, you're going to have to take a number.
Can we talk?
Yeah.
hold that thought. So, she's Cactus, right?
Damien's not onto that. My problem is without his say-so. Unless an ex of kin tell me otherwise, I'm legally obliged to keep her, you know, quote-unquote. I'm already in breach of about 6 laws and 30 guidelines even talking to you.
Yeah.
Do you know the 5 stages of grief? Kubler-Ross model? Denial, anger, bargaining, depression, acceptance?
I'm familiar with bargaining.
And Damien's in denial.
I would have thought he went straight to anger.
So, your relationship with him is... Right. I wonder if that could change.
Glory, Graham Greene. Jurassic Park, Michael Crichton. No, just kidding. It's a joke. To Kill a Mockingbird, Harper Lee.
The Naked Civil Servant by Quentin Crisp. If she knew, why didn't she say anything?
Not that you're gay. I mean, yeah. What'd you expect? The Leif Garrett post is a dead giveaway, don't you reckon?
Can't be any good at this.
At what?
If it's fine for you, you've done this before.
Yeah, and I stuffed it up. Why do you think I'm here? Look, Damien, I'm not where you are right now, but I know where you're headed. And my only recommendation is that you don't go there. Let it go. I didn't. I couldn't. Now she's gone. I stuffed up. She died. By herself. And that's what's going to happen to me if I'm not careful. Mate, you've got to approach this head on. If you don't, it's going to come back around and bite you in the bum. I mean, you don't grow up to be like me, do you?
And the saying is, there's not much chance that a condition will improve. Well, none, if she remains stable.
Right, so is this what Elliot said?
Yeah.
When they told her that,
yeah.
Is that what she said she thought?
No, yeah, what she said. I mean, they're all saying
okay.
The palliative guy,
yeah.
The
well, I mean, is it definite, probable, possible?
Right.
So she said it, or was it some doctor?
She said it. They said it. Right. They're trying to make it more clear to me.
No.
So if you could...
I'll be there.
I mean, I can understand.
If you want me there. Can you help me? With a house? It'll have to be sold.
Sure.
Can you help me with that?
Yeah.
I've never done this before, so I don't know how to... I mean, I suppose our affairs need to be sorted out. Could you help me with a house?
Yeah.
Know what to do.
It's yours to do what you want.
No. I mean, I don't know what she wants. Wanted.
Wants. Yeah, look. Sure, I can help you with the house.
To walk there. I remember, I remember the smell of cabbage. I remember the smell of Dad's Benson and Hedges on his coat and his wardrobe.
Down in the oven. I'm just going to sneak out the back. Take your time. Ah. You first.
Yeah, well, what's the reserve?
There isn't one.
Yeah, it'd have to be mid to late sixes, though, yeah?
I reckon that's about the region, yeah?
We've told you already we can't go past mid fives. Late fives at most.
So what are late fives, you reckon?
75?
Done.
You're kidding. Wait, yourself a 575.
No, I wouldn't, but that's a figure.
That's your figure?
No.
But it's the figure, you know.
Yeah, but...
That's the figure.
Yeah, but there's no, you know...
No. No caveats, no. Lender wants a quick sale, quick settlement. You can do 60-day terms, yeah?
I can talk to the bank.
Talk to the bank. Look, if I was to write the board, I'd say much loved family home. Lender doesn't want it knocked down, some cheap flats put up, doesn't want a jammy jury. It's got a working garden.
She needs a bit of love, though. This old girl here?
Oh, I wouldn't know.
Bit of an agro prune, should we get her going again? I'm an arborist. Tree doctor.
I thought that was in shipping.
How many kids do you have?
Just the one. Oh. Oh, yeah. He's the dad gag, yeah?
That's where I was heading, yeah.
Ah, very good, very good. Your wife,
Julie.
Julie, yeah, you introduced me. She seems,
she'll be fine.
You know, but...
bookshelves. Half of her books are still at her mum's place because we can't fit them in the unit. See, the Dickens tragic.
I'm getting into him. Be good, don't you, right?
I wouldn't know, mate, I'm dyslexic.
Come into my office Monday morning with a 575 figure. Get the paperwork started.
That's it? We're done?
It's deceptively simple, isn't it?
Mate, you sure?
I'm sure.
You want to pop in somewhere, grab a drink to celebrate?
No. Very generous of you, but too early in my recovery for me. Go on. Go on, so I tell you what. Do your twinkle fingers there.